equivalent ratio. Equivalent ratio is nothing but multiplying or dividing the numerator and denominator by a common number. Okay, multiplying or dividing numerator and denominator a common number. Okay, they're given the ratio like this. So I am having, this is my ratio. So my breadth is 1, my length is 2. So I can write 1:2. So in this place 2:4, in this place 4:8. How can I write 1/2, 2/4? The ratio format I am writing. Right. So I can divide. So 1/2, I can multiply by 2. 1 2's are 2, 2 2's are 4. So multiplying numerator and denominator by a common number. So common number 2, I am multiplying numerator and denominator. I am getting this 2/4. Correct. If I am multiplying 2/2, 4/8. So I am getting this common number 4/8. Are you clear? So in this place, the simple form of this is 1:2. If you cancelling this 1, 2. 1 time, this is 2 time. If it is cancelling this, in 4 table is a 1 time. 4 table, 8 is a 2 time. So 1:2. Okay. The ratio of the breadth and length of a rectangle, these three equivalent ratio. So for example, 1:2, 2:4, 4:8. So I can cancel in 2 table, this is 1, this is 2. In 4 table, 1 time, 2 time. So 1:2, 1:2. So each and everything are equivalent only, equal only, that only we are telling. Okay. The easy form, it's only the equivalent format, nothing to worry about this. Okay, it's very easy format. Then 3:7, which one is the equivalent ratio? So I'm having 3/7, I'm multiplying 3 by 3. 3's are 9, 7 3's are 21. If I am cancelling this again, this is equivalent to this. Same 3/7, 2/2, multiplying, so 6, 14. So each and everything is equivalent. That's your wish. If you want to multiply with 10 also okay, 12 also okay, whatever number you need, multiply and divide by that particular same number. So in the ratio 4:5 mark. So in this place 8. So compared to this, in 4 table where it is 8, 4 2's are 8. So 4 2's are 8. Then in this place 5 2's are 10. So I can't find out. So in this place 50. So this is the original ratio 4:5. In 5 table where it is a 50, 5 10's are 50. So obviously, so same number only, your numerator as well as denominator multiply. Okay, if you know your denominator is multiplied with 10, means obviously your numerator also multiply with 10. So what is the ratio? 40. The same 4/5. In 4 table where it is a 12. 4 3's are. So numerator also multiply by 3. So 4 3's are 12. 5 3's are 15. Okay. Same 7/2. In where it is 10, in 2 table 5 10. So numerators are well, denominator multiply by 5. 7 5's are 35. So 7/2, in this place 14. So 7 2's are 14, means your denominator also 2. 7 2's are 14, 2 2's are 4. 7/2, 7 7's are, I am getting 49. Again, I multiply by 7. Denominator also multiply, right? So, 2 into 7, 14. So, each and every value is same only. Okay? So, if a ratio is like that, the given, you're going to... So, if from the ratio to, you find out a equivalent. So, the given. So, they already multiply this term. So, you given simplest form. I don't need this much of the biggest value. So double zero. So in this place, what they given? 4,000. So 4,000. Which one is common? 1,000 is common for both the term. So I can. This is multiplication. This is division equivalent. So this 1,000, this 3 0. So 4. So 5. So 4 is 2. Either I can cancel. In 2 table, it is 2 times the 3 times, right? So 2 by 3, so 2 is to 3. The same in this place, I can cancel this 0, this 0, 0, this 0. So I am having 11 by 55. In 11 table, 11 for 1 time, 55 for 5 time. So I can write in so normal form, 1 is to 5. Okay, you can solve by using the mind calculation. It's very difficult to find out this. That's why I directly cancel to recollect. Okay. So, now we are going to see about your exercise in the next video.